as everyone knows, plastic pollution it really afflicts all the water, land, and everywhere you'll find plastics. Very recently, we had a news that okay, you ban plastic. Now, normally we have 1 to almost 8 million metric tons of plastic going in our environment. It's a huge amount, right? Everyone knows that. And normally the problem is about the smaller one, the carry bags. So I've seen many animals which are like, you know, they'll eat plastic because normally we have a tendency, we'll take the plastic, we'll put the eatables which are not required and we'll throw it in the garbage. And you'll find a lot of animals, domestics, near the garbage. And they will, you know, continuously eat and they cannot differentiate between the plastic and the eatables. They're not intelligent enough to open the bag and eat. Not only domestics, but I have also seen many wild animals. Normally when you're moving in forest, you'll find the tourist, they'll carry a lot of food and they'll throw it outside. And I've seen the deers, I've seen many other animals, monkeys, they'll consume this, they'll eat the plastic along with the eatables. I've seen many times, or it has been published globally that there are, for example, there are a lot of plastic found in the stomach. It enters the system and it remains inside the stomach for a long time. And due to suffocation, the animal would die. There are many incidences, and you'll find more than 140 kgs of plastic in cows. Mostly you'll find in pigs, there are more than 10, 12 kgs. Then you'll have 10 to 12 kgs which was found in the monkey. And the smallest animal which I have seen is a squirrel. This poor little one, it had also consumed plastic. It was a big, big menace. Right. Now, what happens? Is there a solution? Right. Globally, everyone is working on it. I'm sure everyone knows this. There's so many people are working and so many organizations are working on this, that how to reduce the plastic. Everyone is working on this. And I go back to 2016, when I started my own small venture, and I used to grow insects for agriculture. So in the process, I used to keep the larvae of one insect called Galeria melanola. It's a wax moth. So I used to keep those larvae in plastic bag to just make it an economic proposition. Because if I have to give it to the farmer, I have to have it at a very low cost. So I kept it in the plastic bag, and it was very interesting that next day morning when I went to my laboratory, I found everywhere insects. I said, what the gosh, what happened? How did these guys come out? So I collected everyone, I dumped it in the bag again, and that was just regular our carry bag, the bag, which is a garbage bag, black color. So that was very interesting. I collected everything, all the larvae, and kept it back in the bag. And next day, the same story. It was really, you know, painful for me that in the morning I'm going in the lab and I'm finding everywhere you'll find all larvae. Small crawly creepies, they're moving here. Of course, I'm not scared of insects. I'm an entomologist. Entomologist is the one who does a lot of work on insects. And of course, when you see an insect, I'm sure everyone would like to swat it or kill it. But for me, that's a passion. That's my bread and butter. So I do that job. And I collected those insects. I kept those larvae back in the bag. Next day, same story. These guys were outside. Gosh, then I said, okay, what to do now? I collected everyone. I put them back in a small box. That was high density plastic, HD plastic, which you use normally in the kitchens. Then I thought, okay, what to do now? I'm totally busy in figuring out what has happened and why these guys had come out. So I used to ask my lab mates, we have not seen that bag properly, whether it had some holes in it or what. So no, it was a new bag. I took it out from the container and then I have used it. I said, okay, fine. And when I revisited it, I found very interesting thing. These larvae used to eat that plastic and they used to run. I said, okay, that was an escape. I said, chalo, ye, isko bhagna hai, isliye, wo nikal gaya bahar. I said, okay, no problem. Till that time, I started figuring out what to do and started studying about that. What actually is happening behind? And I again kept few larvas with a regular R plastic bag. So that was fantastic. So these guys used to eat. That was an revolutionary thing for me. My God, these guys are eating plastic. So it was really, oh my God, this is what is a big discovery. I used to keep a lot of bags, I used to keep larvas, and they used to eat me. That was a good job. I thought, okay, then I started, I did some good experiments, and I found in 24 hours, these guys are eating a lot of plastic. 24 hours, sumptuous amount of plastic is being degraded. I thought, okay, that's good. Then next day, I did a lot of experiments. And I was interested in what comes out when it eats. Of course, we give out. So the droppings. I was more interested in the droppings. So what are these droppings? Whether it's a manure or what it is. So it was a manure. That was a really big, big discovery for me. I studied that manure with some laboratory equipments, and I found that this is a regular, normal dropping. So I collect them, and I used to grow plants. That was a big revolution again, that to a vegetable. So the concept clicked my mind, it's plastic to veggie on table. So that was really an opening for me. And okay, we can have a solution for the plastic. So I started growing them. Then the question came as, will they reproduce? Yes, they will reproduce. And what happened is, when I used to keep these larvae, they used to eat and they used to go to the next stage. It's called a pupa. So the pupa, after pupation, they go in adult stage. It was really interesting for me to understand what happens then. So these guys started laying eggs. Wow. Interesting for me that they can reproduce. They'll derive nutrition from the plastics. It was really interesting to understand that they can reproduce. So the end question was solved for me. That you have plastic, I can grow vegetables. You bring any amount of plastic, I can convert it into manure. So that's a big, big, big discovery of this. When I did this work. So then there's a issue that now can we really use these larvas in open? Now if anyone wants, can I give these larvas? It's no, because people have a lot of disagreement, or they won't like to have larvas in their home. So many crawly things coming inside the home, no, not accepted. Not even the society will agree on this. So then I thought over it, what actually is happening and what is the one who is doing the job inside their body. I found a lot of interesting thing that there's some kind of an enzyme and some kind of the gut flora inside the stomach who is degrading it, who is breaking it down into the simpler forms. So that is where I found that, okay, I have a solution. Part by part, I can do it. I studied it in very systematic way, and I am, to the end of the story that, okay, yes, this is the solution. After that, I had mind, okay, can you have some kind of an interesting thing that I can come out with some ATM-like centers? That's called an artificial larva. I can create a machine that's an artificial larva where you can come to the center and they can drop the plastic bags and it is converted into manure. So I can support the plastic industry. I can support the environment. So this is a balanced kind of a system, and it's really interesting thing to establish kind of right. And very recent there's which I came with, that is about the styrofoam, thermocol. It's one more burning issue in environment. Thermocol can also be degraded by these small insects, which are very commonly found in our homes, inside stores. Normally you'll find them, those are the rice, normally you'll find them in the rice. So these guys also eat thermocoals. That's a very recent discovery which I have come out with. So that was a very interesting thing for me, that really, really help us a lot. It's a lot of things we can learn from them. It's basically the ones who give us a real way of life. You prepare anything in this environment, they have a solution. This Mother Nature takes care of itself. That's how is a beginning for us to understand what the insects will do for us. That was a big, big an eye-opener for me as well as an entomologist. Thank you.